What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Guapson. I'm back with another video, and today I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I feel like shit, bro. I really do feel like shit. It's just one of those days. So why do I feel like shit, you ask? Well, today officially marks 1 year since XXXTentacion passed away, dude. This shit still fucking haunts me to this fucking day, dude. It really does. It really, really does. This shit, I am not being funny when I say this shit. It really does. Like, I still cannot believe that he is gone. I really cannot believe he's gone. Like, I still refuse to believe it. Like, I still feel like he's out there somewhere. Like, X was that special type of motherfucker. He was that special type of guy that, like, it takes a really special guy to, like, actually make you cry and actually fuck you up inside if he passes away the way he did. Like, how you doing, Siffy? I know you're all happy this morning and everything, but today I wanted to make a video telling you and asking you guys, but more importantly, telling you guys where I was when XXXTentacion passed away. So, let's go ahead and take a stroll down in the basement real quick. So, let me turn this on real quick. As you know, our humble abode, the basement. So, turn these lights on. Okay, so I remember clear as day, bro. I still remember to this day. I was asleep right there on this fucking couch, dude. I was asleep right there on this couch. Well, first, around 12 or 11, I was on my PS4. I had the PS4 hooked up on this 70-inch TV right here. I was playing it for a couple hours, then I decided to take me a quick little nap, and then at that time, around in between 30 minutes to an hour later, my phone started blowing up. So I wake up, and then I just see my phone just like completely blasted with notifications. Like, Twitter is going off, like Instagram's going off. The first thing I saw on my on the lock screen on my phone was an internet link to XXL saying that XXXTentacion was shot in Broward County, and I was like, he got shot? Like, what the fuck? So actually, let me sit down for this. So actually, better yet, let me sit down over here, because this is where I was. This is where I was. So, yes, I was sitting in this exact spot 1 year ago. Exactly 1 year ago, I shedded tons of tears in this exact spot right here. In this exact spot right here, I woke up to the news that XXXTentacion was shot and killed. This shit, and the crazy part is that it didn't even feel like a year ago. It feel like just yesterday he was gone. Just fucking yesterday. And the part that fucked me up the most was that he was such a positive guy. Now, first of all, let me, oh my God. And I really do not want to fucking yell at all in this fucking video, because it's like 8 or 9 a.m. and I just fucking woke up and shit. So let me address some shit real quick. So, if you do not know about X's past, he was, I would say, for lack of a better word, a wild nigga. He was wild and reckless. So, when he was fighting people at his shows, he was doing some wild shit with females. Let me address this fucking beating situation real quick. He did not beat that girl. Whatever y'all think, he didn't. And since they ruled the case as innocent, because he was, and since he passed away and he can't defend himself, that then it's an open and shut case. He didn't do it. So they can't, you can't prove that he did it. So that's number one. Number two, he what else did he do? And it's not like that shit matters anyway because he changed for the better, but and fuck it, dude. It don't even matter, bro. It don't even matter. So then I think a year later, I think, and this was back when he had the half gold and half black dreads and shit. So then he decided like a year later he was gonna change up his clean up his act and everything. He started donating to charities and everything. He started to actually give back to the homeless. He started to help children out that actually and help people out that actually has depression because he had what y'all think of X, like you do not know the whole story. Like he was depressed himself. He had I think he was ADHD, I think. Because I know he had some type of mental disorder and everything. Like I know what he had bipolar disorder. That's what he had. So like some days he would be happy, other days he would be sad, other days he would just be straight up angry, like and other days he would be bitter. So that's what bipolar does to you, bruh. So if you think that if he was just wild and acting out for no reason just for some followers, you're just damn wrong. You're fucking wrong. So, and another thing. So, as you all know, that I am a huge fan of both Trippie Redd and XXXTentacion. Those are both my inspirationals. Those are both my idols. So, the fact that really fucked me up the most was four things. Four things. One, XXXTentacion passed away on Trippie Redd's birthday. That's number one. June 18th is Trippie Redd's birthday, if you didn't know. So, the fact that he lost his best friend on his birthday is just extremely fucked up. And I think I might make another video about this because I don't think that this was just a coincidence. I don't think out of all the 364 days he decides to die or like he dies on Trippie Redd's birthday. I don't think that was a coincidence. I don't think it was. So then that's number one. Number two, Ski Master Slum God. As you all know, Ski Master Slum God is pretty much, it's practically what Ski Mask and X was to y'all. It's pretty much me and my bro Michael, if you watch my channel, is what me and Mike are to each other. So we're practically brothers, but come from different mothers. You get what I'm saying? So the fact that he lost his practical brother, he grew up with this guy. He slept in the same house as this guy. He came up from the same struggle as this guy and came up together. So they're practically brothers from different mothers. So he lost his brother and he had a mental breakdown. It made me even sadder because he lost someone who was an inspiration to him and someone who was so close to him. And this shit is just sad. And another thing is that Father's Day was Sunday. Father's Day was Sunday. Last year, the 18th was on the Monday. So X's dad lost him a day after Father's Day. He lost him a day after Father's Day. This shit is just... And the person I feel bad for the most is his mother, because his mother is such an awesome person. I've seen interviews with her, and she's not seeking no clout and no attention off of X's death. She is not, because at the end of the day, X was his son, X was her son, and y'all got the audacity to say that she's clout chasing? Like, what? So... And let me address one more thing about this shit. And then I think I'm going to go edit this video because it's like 9 a.m. and I want to post this at around like 2 o'clock. So a couple things actually. So number one, I know it took me like at least a good 2 weeks before I was actually officially back to normal. I was straight up having
all type of mood swings for like the next 2 weeks after I heard the news. Like, some days I would just wake up crying. Some days I would just wake up mad as hell. Some days I would just wake up like tearing down a whole city block. Some days I would just want to strangle somebody. It's just so many shit that I just want to explain. I just know I can't because the FBI is going to show up at my front door. So, like, after that, bro, it took me a good 2 weeks because, like, drawing, as you know, drawing, I'm an artist. Drawing makes me calm. Whenever I'm feeling down, I look to draw. So, and as a matter of fact, I'm actually planning on making, a little piece for, in commemorance to X, when I get done with this video because I got 6 drawings I need to post and finish with, but, and that's one more thing. Now, the other thing that I want to discuss is that, this new age of disrespect. Now, I'm telling you, bro, this shit is about to make me fucking, I don't even want to even touch on this shit, but I know I have to. This disrespectful shit coming from niggas these days. I tell you one thing. I immediately wake up and then I post a couple tweets on Twitter. And then I see some of my favorite YouTubers, my favorite celebrities, pay homage and pay respect to X and everything. And you just got these disrespectful motherfuckers in the comment sections and the replies and shit, and this shit just pissed me off so fucking bad, dude. It really does. Like, you motherfuckers would sit up here and wait till a motherfucker is dead, a motherfucker passed away a whole fucking year ago, and you motherfuckers want to sit up here and disrespect the fucking dead. I'm not fucking spiritual, but I hope y'all see X in y'all fucking dreams and shit. I hope y'all do. I hope he haunts y'all in y'all fucking dreams and shit. I'm not a spiritual guy, but that needs to happen to you niggas that's disrespecting him. Because this shit has been going on for a whole fucking year, dude. This shit has been going on for a whole fucking year. And I'm honestly sick and fucking tired of it. I'm sick and fucking tired of it. So, that's really all I wanted to say. Now, they have caught the killers. Now, the thing is, these 4 disrespectful punk ass, and I'm not going to show their face or say their names because I'm not going to give them the satisfaction of what they want. And that's some clout and fucking attention for what they did. So, they caught these motherfuckers, and first we thought it was that, what was that motherfucker name? Soulja Kid or Soulja, I think it was Soulja Kid or something. Like, and it, we actually made a mistake. It wasn't him. So, we actually caught the 4 killers and everything. So, like, I don't know when the fuck they're going to be put on trial, but I hope it's ASAP because these motherfuckers need 50 to life. And that, honestly, they need to start coming up with a law saying that if you murder a celebrity, it's doubled because they're a celebrity. So, that's all I wanted to say, bro. Like, can't believe it's been 1 year since I've been sitting on, since I was sitting in this spot and crying my fucking eyes out, bro. It really is a damn shame, bro. That's one of the one things that I wish that if they made time travel possible, I will go back and actually save X. I don't care how much it fucks the space-time continuum up, I'm gonna do it. Like, this is one of those things that just needs to be done. So, let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Like, if I get my monetization back, this video will not be put any ads on it at all. It will not. I don't care how many views it gets. Like, I'm not putting any ads on it in the future. So, comment down below, where were you guys at when X was killed, bruh? Because this shit still haunts me to this fucking day. It really does. So, let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. I'm gonna go post this online and shit. I'm gonna listen to X while I do it. And, make sure you guys like and subscribe if you're new. This your boy, Guap. And I'm signing out, bruh. Peace.